Throughout history, people have come up with different ways to conduct experiments. In the 17th century, an Italian by the name of Francesco Redi came up with the idea that flies cause maggots on rotten food, and not the rotting food itself. He tested this idea by placing pieces of meat in flasks and controlled his experiment so that all the flasks were exactly the same, but for one thing. Half were covered with a cloth to stop the flies, and half were not. When maggots only appeared in the uncovered flasks, he could be pretty sure that the rotting meat didn't create the maggots. This also gave him good reason to say that life could not spontaneously pop into existence, which was a widely held belief at the time. Controls in an experiment help us single out the things we want to measure, but sometimes these controls are not enough. In more complex situations, our brains can make it too easy for us to see the things we most want to see. If researchers have spent a lot of time and money in preparing an experiment, they might hope to see a positive result. But how can they ensure that their own expectations don't bias the outcome? This is where blinding comes in. Blinding means the researchers who study an experiment's results aren't given all the information about the experiment. This way, any patterns they find are less likely to be the result of a personal bias. In some medical experiments, even blinding is confused by the placebo effect, where the very act of getting treatment can make people feel better. This makes it difficult to tell what is causing changes in a patient's health, the treatment or the act of receiving treatment. This effect is countered by using pretend drugs, placebos, and real drugs in the experiment and comparing the outcome. This requires not only the researchers to be blinded, but also the people in the experiment. This is called double blinding. Of course, some things are too complex or distant to isolate and test. For example, ecosystems, climate, and far-off planets. But when possible, blinding and finding ways to control the variables we can results in more solid evidence to support our idea.